So happy 4th of July to my Americans out there. Tomorrow is 4th of July, obviously, and I don't have videos on Tuesday, so I'm saying it to you guys now. Happy 4th of July. But going back to the video, I wanted to take a few minutes with this video to talk about two interesting PlayStation 5 stories and, of course, the top 5. And if you could hit that like button on the video, thank you to those that do it. And as always, it's very much appreciated. Now, the topics I wanted to dive into today includes the next major update and the top 5 most wanted features by you guys. It was interesting to go through the comments from my previous video and Twitter. Alongside that, we're going to talk about PS5 exclusive Silent Hill 2's release date, and Last of Us 3 and Factions 2 seem to have gotten new information. We're going to go over that as well. First, yes or no, do you want a Last of Us Part 3 or not? For me personally, as you guys already know, I've said this before, I didn't really like the story in part 2, so I'm not really interested in a part 3, but that's just me. I'd take a new IP over Last of Us Part 3. Again, just me. What about you guys? So comment below, yes or no, if you'd want a Last of Us Part 3 or not. Let me know down in the comments below. Now, diving into the first story of the video, Last of Us Part 3 and Factions 2. So over the weekend, we had two pieces of Naughty Dog supposed information making the rounds. First one came from Daniel Richman over on Twitter, who has a user base of 300,000 people on Twitter. He posted a link to his Patreon sharing supposed Last of Us Part 3 information. But when I first heard the information that he was sharing, this sounded like Factions 2 information to me. Reading from Insider Gaming, Last of Us Part 3 casting details, which spoke about a series of characters surviving on the outskirts of a post-apocalyptic city crammed into a Victorian house that serves as their base. It referenced 5 characters that Naughty Dog is seeking to cast: Lucas, Mason, Val, Ezra, and Gracies. It sounded a little bizarre, with there being a note that part of the story sees Ezra try to take the house from Val. It's the apocalypse. There are plenty of empty houses. Given that there's absolutely no information of the core cast or story from The Last of Us Part 2, it's highly likely that if this leak is found to be true, it concerns Factions, the upcoming multiplayer, potentially an extraction shooter coming from Naughty Dog. So that was some of the information that Daniel posted on his Patreon. So the rumors we've heard in regards to Factions 2 is that it could have a Factions 1 like mode, which I really care about, alongside a Division like extraction shooter mode. Reading this, it falls in line with what Factions 2 is reported to be in terms of the extraction shooter side of things, and I think Daniel possibly has confused the two. Possibly. This is also probably done considering Factions 2 was set to potentially be shown earlier this year, but that was delayed reportedly because of Bungie. So I assume this casting stuff is already done and they've already filmed some of this stuff and that they were potentially ready to show some of this stuff this year. Now, the second piece of information comes from Viewer Anon on Twitter, who stated this: look, it's early, story details are to be tweaked, everything is potentially up in the air to be changed, but I assure you I've heard Ellie is at least as important in Last of Us Part 3 as she was in Part 2. All I can say is I've been very vocal for quite a while that Last of Us Part 3 is in development and others are finally noticing major filming happening this year. Last year, Viewer Anon claimed that the next game from Naughty Dog to be The Last of Us Part 3 from Neil Druckmann. This is surprising, obviously, considering Neil Druckmann earlier this year gave off the impression that the team has already started working on a new IP after The Last of Us 2. Taking in that The Last of Us 2 came out in 2020, their new IP could have been in the works not long after that, and Neil could have potentially handed that off to someone else to finish off at this point and is now starting on The Last of Us Part 3, like, beginning section. Early development. Let's see what we get. All I hope for is Factions 2, a Factions 2 reveal this year. That's crazy to say, considering not too long ago I was hoping the game itself would release this year. Now, diving into the second story of the video, Silent Hill 2 Remake. So this is a quick story. There's a screenshot of a conversation that was posted on a Discord server, according to site Fandomware, that showcased an Instagram conversation with Luke Roberts, who plays James in Silent Hill 2 Remake. He was asked about the game's release date, and he said, early next year, I believe. So The main actor probably has some knowledge on the release date of the game, maybe, but again, this isn't confirmed. And since this image was deleted from what I'm reading here, we don't know if this actually happened, this conversation actually happened. But considering we haven't seen anything from Silent Hill 2 Remake since last year, early 2024 doesn't seem crazy. It seems possible. But you guys let me know if you think Silent Hill 2 Remake is a 2024 game, or is it still a 2023 game? Let me know down in the comments below. And now diving into the final topic of the video, top 5 most wanted features for update 8.0 for the PlayStation 5. So this list was constructed by you guys. I walked through your comments on my Twitter post a while ago alongside my recent video, both asking what features you guys want on the PlayStation 5. This is a list of 5 features that you guys most wanted, but I honestly could have made a top 10. You guys had a lot of features that you guys wanted for the PlayStation 5 that you believed were missing. But let's dive into this top 5, starting off with number 5. Number 5 is folders on the main screen. This one made me happy to see because you guys already know I want folders on the main screen. We have game lists in our libraries to organize our games, but that's not the same as having a folder in the home screen to quickly access a collection of games. Number 4. Number 4 is a web browser. This is a feature I also want in official form. Right now, you can access the web browser by sending a message on your PlayStation 5 that's a link to Google, for example. You can click the link on the message and it'll open up the browser that's already in the system and direct you to Google. And from there, you can go anywhere you want. But I don't want to go through these hoops. I'd rather an official web browser on the PlayStation dashboard that I can go to directly. Number 3. Number 3 is quick resume, a quick resume like feature. People want to be able to hop in between multiple games, similar to how Xbox Series X has it. Right now, you have a resume feature on PlayStation 5, but obviously, that's not like Xbox's feature where you can jump between multiple games. I've said this before, I will say it again, quick resume on Xbox is a bit buggy, so if Sony is going to do a feature like this, they'd have to make sure it works properly. Number 2. Number 2 is dynamic themes. This one was obviously going to be on the list. This was a big one, a big feature for the PlayStation 4 home screen. It made your home screen feel like your own home screen. Everybody had something different. But on the PlayStation 5, there are no dynamic themes. 3 years in almost, and we still don't have them. And I've been hearing about people wanting dynamic themes for a while now. Multiple times across any video that I talk about features, updates, and stuff like that, people want dynamic themes. And of course, the number one most wanted feature on this list is PS3 backwards compatibility. This was a mix of people wanting full backwards compatibility with disc support and others just wanting the ability to download PlayStation 3 games and not have to stream them anymore. This was also a mix of people wanting better backwards compatibility for PlayStation 2 and PS1 games as well, but mainly it focused on PS3 backwards compatibility. This one also shouldn't be a big shocker. I think people have been asking for this, including myself, for a long time at this point. And that's our top 5. Obviously, don't go expecting these features to be on PS5 update 8.0, but we'll keep doing these to highlight what you guys want. And of course, if you guys enjoy these types of videos, but you guys let me know if you agree with this list or not. Let me know down in the comments below. And if you guys did enjoy this video, please hit that like button. As always, helps and subscribe if you're new. I got new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And now I'll check you guys out on the next one. And welcome back to the After Show. This is the part of the video where we have a little fun down in the comments below. If you're old, welcome back. If you're new, welcome. For today's thing, what I want you guys to do is the body, obliterate, destroy, and overall harass the comment section with Happy 4th of July. Tomorrow's 4th of July, Independence Day for my Americans out there who follow the channel. Happy 4th of July to you guys. And if you guys want to celebrate like we did for Canada Day for the Americans on the channel, destroy the comment section with Happy 4th of July. And I'll definitely heart those comments like I always do because I appreciate everybody who stays to the end of my videos. And now I'll check you guys out on the next one.